My thing is, what you literally need to do to remain, like, on top, just tease the fuck out of everyone and never give them a nut. Like, look at everything like a huge orgasm. Like, all right, if you see this girl on the street, this girl gives you the attention that you crave, this girl fucks with you time to time, this girl kisses you, touches you, but never fucks you, never gives you head, never gives you what you're craving, you know? You're gonna endlessly chase her. You're either gonna get frustrated and be like, oh, fuck that bitch, and da da da, or you're gonna endlessly chase her because you're never gonna get what you want. And if you never get what you want, you're always gonna crave it. In the bottom of your mind, whenever the opportunity presents itself, you're gonna chase it. So my thing is, like, if you have too much fucking ice cream, you're not gonna want any more ice cream. If you have too much of me, you're not gonna want too much of me. If you have too much of ski, you're not gonna want too much of me. So too much of anything is a horrible thing.
I see black skies and white lies. I'd rather be dead, filling my head with different enemies.
What's your ultimate dream? If you could be anything you want to be with, what would it ultimately be? The last stop. A lot of you motherfuckers won't even know because you never even thought about it. And that's cool, but now is the time to begin to think about it. So you know, wherever you at, nigga, everybody start in the mud. Everybody start with a fucking altar mug, me son, and that's a blessing.
Everybody's going to get their chance. Whether you play ball, whether you play football, whether you box, whether you wrestle, whether you fucking swim, whether you want to be the next fucking Michael Phelps, you want to be the next track star, you want to be the next fucking guy that races cars and shit. If you want to design the best car, design the next fucking phone, design the next big laptop, the next shoe, the next sock, the next pants, the next fucking hat, everybody's going to get their turn, literally. And I want everybody to acquire this knowledge and acquire this hope. Everybody will get their turn. What you speak to the world and craving is craving and ambition and wanting anything is the way to speak to the world. If you want something so bad and you speak it into power, you wish it into power, it's gonna happen.
Everyone dreams of a successful life, but how many truly believe they can achieve it? The key is within you, and it all starts with your mindset and belief.
Positive thinking isn't just about ignoring challenges. It's about approaching them with a mindset that believes in possibilities, growth, and resilience. When you choose to think positively, you open doors to possibilities and attract better experiences into your life.
I see black skies and white lies. I'd rather be dead, filling my head.
The law of attraction is a principle that says, like attracts like. When you focus on positive thoughts, you draw positive things into your life. Picture your goals. Feel grateful as if you've already achieved them, and watch how opportunities appear.
The universe doesn't give you what you want. The universe gives you who you are. People misunderstand that. They think the law of attraction is being obsessed with what you want. But no, if you want something, it doesn't mean you're going to get it. The universe will reflect to you what you are. And Beckwith calls this the law of resonance. So you got to become that which you seek to be. Now, lofty questions works because it's actually getting you there. So when you ask a question such as, why do I have the fit muscular body of an athlete? You're tricking your subconscious by shifting your identity, and you will find that the universe will start to reflect that. If you ask yourself a question, why am I so kind and compassionate to everyone around me? Or why do I only eat healthy foods? Or why am I so brilliant at being an entrepreneur? You are shifting your identity at a fundamental level, almost like self-hypnosis, and the universe will start to reflect that, and your life will start accelerating and changing at a really rapid pace. This is actually the most effective manifesting technique I know. But if you sit down and you hope and you hope and you try to focus your mind on one thing over and over and over again, doesn't mean you're going to get that.
The reality of the law of attraction is up to you. It's your life, your choices, and your journey to explore what works for you. It's never too late to give it a try, but don't sleep on it.